Well, hello everyone. Welcome to Kirby's Return to Dreamland. No, Kirby's Return to Dreamland, Day 2. So yesterday we did all of World 5, we beat Grand Doomer, did all of World 6, and if had a bunch of stream interruptions. And we also beat Metal General. So now, time for Dangerous Dinner. And also, in the first time in this whole playthrough, because I played a lot of it off stream, like, yeah, I was away from home, so I basically played all of World 1 through 5 off stream because trying to fix the chat thing here. Hey, sorry about that. Let's get back to the main event. As you can see, Revolution Beam is my favorite move in Kirby. Got our Magaland ticket. Let's continue. Why do I have a weird feeling that there's gonna be something up here? I don't even remember anything being, like, up. Well, nothing was there. But it didn't hurt to check. Just really sucks having this cold. It's really annoying. Like, my brother's out here being like, "Oh, Allie, stop doing that. It's so annoying." And I'm like, "Well, of course it's annoying. I'm not enjoying this either." Thank God it's the first one. I don't want to go back and get any more. We're nearly done with the game as it is. Okay, yeah. I know we have the Magalore epilogue. But we're gonna do that later. Thank you. Every day's a good day for revolution, Bean Baby. But verily, every good day must come to an end. Check me out. Yeah, let's hope there's no more water puzzles after this. Holy crap, that was Blarg Yoshi's Island! And that's Blarg Yoshi's Island again! Oh, and it's the worst ability in the game, Tornado! Don't at me! I know people have their reservations about Bomb, but Tornado is just categorically better, and I'm gonna stand by that until I die. If there ever comes a day where I stop slandering Tornado, that means I'm dead. Fuck that one up. Nothing to do but try again. We'll get it. Let's see, does touching these buttons do anything? No. Thank you. Wait. I think I'll try something out. We did it. Well, that headache's over. I'm sorry, that was such a... That was, like... I think that's the first time I ever died in Kirby's Return to Dream Land with a super ability, like, ever. Like... I'm talking, like... I didn't do this when I was, like... When I was 12, originally playing the game. Twice. As I said earlier, nothing to do but keep trying. Three times. And I thought I had the timing down right. As I said, never give up. Even when the world's telling you should give up. World 6 really isn't gonna let up on us. No, why do I say World 6? This is World 7. I mean, earlier I called... I called World... I almost called World 6 World 5. That's literally just Hypernova. Oh my god! Kirby's Return to Dreamland. Kirby's Return to Dreamland, like, predicted Kirby Triple Deluxe. Who would have thought? By the way, that was really, like, clever. I don't like sand. It's coarse, rough, irritating, and it gets everywhere. That's all I have to say about this ability. In reality, I do like it. It's fun, a nice addition. Sand Kirby's really cute. I like how we can build sand castles. Yeah, I literally just checked the info so I can do that. Yes, I am aware that was an Ooka Peka Lukanen moment. Welp, we beat Brazil. Yes, I know that meme is like almost a decade old, but it doesn't get old. It's still funny. Like, whenever a team loses 7-1, like, regardless of the sport, I'll just spam Brazil emojis. It's still funny. Like, there are just some sports memes that age like fine wine and never get old. As there's a drive into deep left field by Castellanos, that'll be a home run. So that'll make it a 4-0 ball game. I don't know if I'll ever be putting on this headset again. Sometimes you have to sacrifice, and it will pay off. Yes? I'm streaming.
Oh,
hi.
You actually put on the game, and then you left.
Well, I wanted to do it while I was eating. Sorry about my dad. Uko Pekka Lukanen moment. No, it wasn't my dad interrupting, that was the Uko Pekka Lukanen moment. It was the way I basically fell into an unavoidable pit trap. Wait, where's the water moan for this? That was a wheel Uko Pekka Lukanen moment. Oh. So what I was saying. So you have to using water gun is only available with this Kirby when you're on water. Time for some high jump hijinks. Time your jumps, kids. Time your jumps. Honestly, high jump is a fun ability. Oh no. Looks like we're gonna have to restart. Yeah, I don't think having high jump is a good idea right here. Okay, we have to stay on the lookout. There it is. Yeah. Jesus Christ! Becca Lukanen moment. That's the first time I ever died in a stage that wasn't to by losing health, that wasn't to a boss. Okay, now we're back where we were. Allie completely forgot how to use high jump. What a travesty. That cost us some very... Keep hammering away. There's actually a part in this game where you have to use, like, the whole size controls on this thing. Like, usually it's just use the biggest size and you'll be good. Holy shit, is that Divine Beast Varudania? Holy crap! Kirby's Return to Dreamland predicted Breath of the Wild! Let's smash this big boy now. Oh, a diagonal aisle scroller. Thought the door would never come. Speaking of sleep, Kirby, I remember first time we played Star Allies, I tried to prank my boyfriend into getting sleep, Kirby. Thank you. I mean, I didn't know it was, like, an opening and closing thing. Yep, there's the music. Just in time. Thank you. That did not just happen. Do I have the worst luck with this? Holy shit, that was so tense. Like, I was just on the edge of my seat there. Heart was pounding. Now, time for one of the most iconic sequences in the game. Get ready for this. Yep, the music changes, so you know it's gonna be great. Like, this is one of the parts of the game I most clearly remember from when I was a kid. Like, the absolute satisfaction of just grinding every single boss you faced to dust. With your super ability. and Kirby sawed a damn mountain in half. To show how powerful Ultra Sword is, I sawed this mountain in half. Okay, Claude? Hey, Archer Kirby wasn't introduced till Triple Deluxe. I beg your pardon. Okay, random ability gave us spear, so we're using spear. And we have to fight two of them at once. In other words, this is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them. Now let's go on a star tour, because after this, we've got some big things to do. Boss comes early on this one. And I got all the Island Spheres. It's pretty nice. What shall we do? How shall we fight Landia? Honestly, let's stick with spear. Oh no, not Pyribbit! Pyribbit was the worst boss in Triple Deluxe. Well, they say that four heads are better than two. Time to take it up a notch! Yeah, I don't think Spear Kirby was best choice here. You know what? I'm gonna use Bomb Kirby to prove all the Bomb Kirby haters wrong. Because Bomb Kirby is good. As said, Bomb Kirby is good. Now let's go get this Master Crown and give it back to Magalore. I'm sure nothing bad will happen. Bravo, Monsieur Kelpie! You've truly earned your reputation as an hero. Your help defeating Landia was invaluable. Ugh, at long last is mine. The source of the limitless power, the Master Crown. Obtaining this crown has been my ultimate goal all along. What's with all the weird looks? Fine, let me explain everything. I fought Landia by myself and lost, so Platypopter. That's when the thought struck me. I could have you defeat Landia for me. A stroke of genius, I know. You even helped me repair my Star Cartera. I really did appreciate that, by the way. Anyway, the time has come for your planet! No! The time has come for the entire universe to bow down to moi! And for being such a big help in all of this, your planet gets to go burst. Prepare to bow, Popstar! Welcome your new overlord. Sorry for the terrible French accent. It was all moving really fast. And now, time for another Kirby tradition. The shmup final boss part. Amazing Mirror had it, Star Allies had it. Did it? I think it did. Yeah, Planet Robobot had it. That was funny? Thank you. I tried my best. The accent is very, very odd. Oh, you say? However, you said yourself that Michael Hoch should have the French accent. So, I oblige you. Even though it sounds very bad like. Monsieur Kirby. Monsieur Kirby, what did it? Le Night de Meta. Bandana D. That's how Magalore would say all of those. Magalho. Ah! The universe is mine! Now, you must fight Z. What stakata? Zilloch. Zimagaloch. Yes, Kirby 64 and also Adventure had it too. Thank you. Monsieur Kirby, now is the time that you beat your end. How you say? Your dragon friends stand no chance. Absolutely no chance. Monsieur Rabich, it's time. It's time. Yeah, I'm gonna choose Becca Kirby. Because it's OP. Monsieur Kirby. We fight for the universe. Monsieur Kirby, time for phase two. Monsieur Kirby, Hadouken. No, Hadouken! Monsieur Kirby, phase 3! Hadouken. No, Monsieur Kirby. This will not be so easy as you think. Oh, Monsieur Kirby, it is time for the last stand, no? Monsieur Kirby, it is the time for you to be crowned a bitch. Yeah. you win! Mokyo Kabe! No! 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 Impossible! No! No! All fuck, Kabe. Get your ass ready, Kabe. Oh, not the revolution beam. No, the beam de revolution, huh? Since you usually get a full heal. I don't feel bad using this. I don't think I ever got past this part. The square! That is my... the most powerful attack I can muster. Get ready for phase 3. No, phase 5. Just remember, kids, no matter what your question is, the answer is Revolution Beam. I just beat Magalore with a Revolution Beam. Monsieur Kabe. I forget how to say I'm sorry in Spanish. I beat Magalore with a Revolution Beam. I beat Magalore with a Revolution Beam. That is one of my life's biggest accomplishments. That tops graduating from high school, graduating from college. like getting a 5 on my AP Calc BC exams. Wheel. Yep, it was a real deal. And so, Kirby and his friends returned home to Planet Popstar. Tired from their adventure, they just wanted to nap a bit. Because it was pretty hard, honestly. But then Kirby sees a butterfly. What could that butterfly even mean? He inquires with his friends, Bandana D, Meta Knight, and of course, King Dedede, about the butterfly, but King Dedede got his head stuck in somewhere. But now he has a flower on his head. Kirby is quite surprised by this information. He looks really good with that flower and that suspicious butterfly. And then he sees the Laura Starcutter return to its full form. Kirby was quite happy that the Laura Starcutter wasn't trying to kill him anymore. And now that Magalore was dead, he would never have to deal with them anymore. The end. I love this game, honestly. Just thanks to Nintendo and HAL Labs for deciding to remake this. It was, I played it a lot when I was a kid, so I'm obviously like really attached to it. Not my first Kirby game though. That was Epic Yarn. DDD with his lack of neck. DDD is the one. Big thanks to Shinya Kumazaki. Quite a debut in, no. His debut was Superstar Ultra. But this game, like, it took 10 years to develop, so I think it's fitting that it took 12 years for me to finally finish the game. Cause yeah, I am like 90% sure I kinda gave up on Magalore when I was younger. Like, this game was such a good nostalgia trip. Ah, Mr. Duder, rest in peace. I'm just really glad this game exists. I mean, I said it once, I'll say it again. I'm glad it exists. Because I was just able to relive, like, so many memories. Like, I remember being in middle school, and it was a really hard time for me. I'd go home, and I, like, after I did all my homework, I'd play this game. Even though it was a Wii game, nobody really wanted to play with me, so it was just me. and I had a lot of fun with it. It's just so awesome to see this game back. So, all I can hope for is that there's some depressed 12-year-old kid out there who has a hard time in school, but they'll come home and they'll have their copy of Kirby's Return to Dreamland Deluxe. And they'll play it, and everything will feel better, if just for a few moments. That's all I could ask for. Based on the work of the development team from the original Wii version, just, by the way, I just want to give my big thanks to both all the developers on, like, the original back in 2011, and this one, and the remake. Y'all did great. You really did great. Thought HAL Labs' logo was some kind of monster, but some kind of three-eyed monster. But apparently it's just a dog who's laying some eggs. But wait! There's more! Traitor Magalore. Who would have thought Magalore was a twist villain? Oh wait, I did beat the game. Because I remember trying extra mode and not liking it. Dogs don't lay eggs. Yeah, they don't. Unless somebody makes like a dog bird that does. They don't lay eggs. Yeah, I don't feel like doing extra mode, honestly. It wasn't really fun, but Magalore's adventure isn't over yet. You can now play Magalore Epilogue, the Interdimensional Traveler. I said Travelore! ~95%. What am I missing? Well, yeah, I think it's just the challenge stages, but Let's go on a quick visit to Merry Magaland. But yeah, next stream we're gonna do the Magalore epilogue. Copy essence? Bonkers! Metal General's here. That Kyogre looking ass. Now we can look like Kyogre as well. Landia! We love you, Landia. But where's Magalore? The world may never know. Let's find the hidden Magalores. I'm usually very good at finding them, guys. There's one. Nothing could compare the nostalgia rush to, like, finding a hidden Magalore and then hearing, like, the Wii channel music from the original Return to Dreamland. That simply just hits different. Oh, they're both right there. Before we leave, time for one of my favorite things in the game. Amazing Mirror, I love you. Well, I think this music is good to end the stream on. Very relaxing. I'll be back in like the next 2 days. Doing the Magalore epilogue. I hope you all enjoyed. And see you later, alligators. You won a game by sacrificing the rook! Congrats.